Hi students, in this video I am going to talk 7th standard students, and in the previous class what we have talked about students, we have talked about facts behind the sericulture process, the people facing problems in sericulture process, health issues, the people facing health issues in sericulture process, and the length of the silk fiber produced by the single cocoon, and on an average length that we have talked about in the last class. And also we talked about the things made of wool and the sources of wool that we get from that. I have given you as a homework. I think you have done that homework, students. So here let me continue that. And today in this video, what are we going to talk? Wool. Okay. Sources of wool. The animals list, you know, the animals list. Goat, sheep, camel, yak, etc. Okay, students. Here, these are the sources of wool that we get from, and how the people rear them. You know, some goats and sheep live in different geographical areas, like Kashmir, you know. Jammu and Kashmir. Goat and sheep are reared in Jammu and Kashmir because the place is very cool and the animals, they have rich wool on their body. You know, the animals which live in Jammu and Kashmir have more wool on their body because the place is cool. Wool prevents to escape the heat from our body or from that animal's body. You know, the animal which lives in cool place should not be affected by the cool temperature. Then their body is modified by growing more wool on their body. Okay, what is the use of the wool? The body temperature is not lost. They do not lose their body temperature and they do not get affected by the cool temperature. So the body temperature cannot escape from the body. Okay, and the wool on the animal's body traps the temperature. Okay, traps the temperature. So body, the wool do not allow transfer heat from and to body of animals living in cool areas, cool places. From means from that animal's body, to means from environment to the body. It doesn't allow to transfer the heat so that the animals can live comfortably without affecting any kind of problems by the cool temperatures there. Okay, and here, and also the wool, is it right? Here, the wool of these animals its collectively called as fleas or fur. Fleas or fur, you know, that's nothing but hair. Wool is nothing but what? Hair of the animal. You know, the animals have two types of hair on the body. One is coarse hair, another one is fine hair. Coarse hair is fur, fine hair is fleas. Okay, this collectively called as wool. But here we need only fleas. Fleas is very soft hair that's used to make fabrics, woolen fabrics. Okay, and fur is also used to make other articles and other things that you will see in your coming classes. Okay, right? And here coarse and fine. Coarse hair, it's nothing but rough hair. See here, the coarseness or roughness or fineness or softness depends upon the type of animal. You know, the coarseness or roughness or softness of this wool, that depends upon what type of animal. If you take sheep or goat and camel, yak, in which animal the wool is soft and in which animal the wool is rough? Can you expect? Yes, the wool in goat and sheep is soft comparing to the wool in camel and yak. Yes or no? Yes. So the wool obtained from goat and sheep has its own importance, and the wool obtained from camel and yak has their own importance. Okay? See students, here let us talk about the quality of the wool obtained. What? Quality of wool obtained from different animals. See, let us take sheep and camel. Let us take sheep and camel. The sheep which lives in Jammu and Kashmir has very soft hair and its length is around 2 to 5 inches and more soft hair present, but its length is 2 to 5 inches. But here is camel which lives in Rajasthan. The camel which lives in Rajasthan has more rough hair. Okay, it has rough and less soft hair. Almost soft hair is absent. See, what is the reason for that? The more soft hair has more capacity to protect the animal from coolness, and which lives in Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir, the place is very cool, right? So that the body of the sheep, you know, the wool produced by that sheep is modified like that. You know, more soft hair is there comparing to the camel which lives in Rajasthan. You know, the Rajasthan is desert area, right? Desert place. In the desert place, the place is very hot and more rough hair, almost less soft hair, means the soft hair is almost absent. Okay, the camel may have the soft hair, but that cannot be cut, that cannot be trimmed. But the rough hair can be trimmed and used to make different other articles. Okay, students, and this is how the quality of the wool depends upon the place of the animal's live and the temperature, you know, the type of the animal's live. Okay, they adopt the environmental conditions. The body is modified based on the climatic conditions present in different geographical areas, students. Okay, next, here let me give you the name of the sheep which lives in Jammu and Kashmir is Merino sheep, and also goat, Angora. Angora goat. Here Angora goat, Merino sheep, which live in Jammu and Kashmir, and it not only produces 2 to 5 inches long fleece, but also produces 5 to 18 kilograms of wool in a year. Okay, so that it's very valuable. We can say the wool obtained from Angora goat and Merino sheep is very qualitatively very valuable, and it's also costly. That you have to understand. Now I would like to give you homework, students. Make a list of the places where wool is obtained in our country. Okay, the homework I would like to give you is, list of places where wool is obtained. Okay, so wool is obtained. This you have to take it as homework, students. Okay, I want you to present it in our WhatsApp group. This is for this video, students. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.